do it all over again. So that was basically the end of the road. So now we're going south on the 16. Through the Capay Valley. And I think the little twisty part is called the Rumsey Canyon or something like that. The winds come from the northwest around here, so it's always nice to ride south on this bike. There's so much buffeting. It's nice to kind of get out of the wind a little. There's the Prius from earlier. Some rocks on the way up here, so that is something to watch out for. There's a motorcyclist's favorite sign. The best ones are the ones where it says, curvy road for the next, it'll say like 30 miles or, apparently there's a freeway up north, I think it's the 36, where it tells you twisty road for the next 140 miles, and that's kind of a goal. I would love to ride that road someday. So the scenery here is pretty nice too, so not much time to focus on it right now, but if you're just want to cruise through here. It is beautiful. Just want to look at everything. It'll probably be nicer in the winter. Everything's dead right now. And there'll be more water flowing through this little canal thing. Supposed to be loose on the handlebars, but it's just it's just mentally hard to do. It just doesn't seem logical. I watched a video, there's some water there. There was a guy doing a review, I think on the Yamaha R6, I think his name is Adam Wahid. And when he goes around the track, he grips the throttle with just his fingers, like his fingers and his thumb. And that's how he's twisting it around the track. And it's, you know, that's kind of the way of not putting too much pressure on the bars. Oh no! No! That was nice, man. Bumps in the road, it's not completely smooth, so when you're kind of going through the turn, there will be there are bumps in there. trying to do this whole thing in fifth gear. I used to look at the speed limit signs and try and kind of use that as a guide. But it's just, it doesn't, it's really no point. Unless it says like 15 miles per hour, then you, I don't know, you really need to slow down. But if it's 35 to 40, you can kind of just eyeball it. It's kind of scenic, I don't know, but you know, if you have a sport bike, you kind of want that part. If you go further down, that's where Cache Creek Casino is. You want to go there and eat, gamble, and then do the whole thing again. Or you can turn around somewhere right here and do the whole thing again. And, yeah, that's the Highway 16 ride.